In today's video, we're gonna take a look at the accessibility of a document that has been signed using DocuSign. Welcome to the Accessibility Guide channel. My name is Sean Jordison, and let's jump right in. I have a form that has been created using Adobe Acrobat Pro DC, and it currently is accessible. We have our figure tag, H1, our form fields, everything looks pretty good. I have created an account on DocuSign and we're gonna try to get this file signed so we can review the accessibility of it. I'm going to drag my file into DocuSign and it looks like we need to add in an address. Let's see, I'm gonna put in my own address in here and then needs to sign. Let's do next. Convert PDF form fields. What would you like to do? We'll keep PDF form data. Do confirm. I want to add my signature field here to the signature area. We'll hit done and select send. All right, so it was sent. I'm going to check my email now and open up the email to review the document. We'll hit continue. I need to select sign. We will sign it, finish. Now let's go ahead and look at the completed document. I'm going to download the file in my other window and open it here. In Adobe Acrobat Pro. Let's open up the tags panel. We have figure, H1, P tag. We have our form fields in here. Wow, and then we actually have the figure tag. Let's right click and select properties. I was curious as to what's gonna be read there. I'm gonna go ahead and launch JAWS and let's see how this document is read.
Form sample data, the accessibility guide load.
Oh, that's cool that it actually changed the form fields to read only.
Sean Jordison.
All right, let's see how the signature comes up.
Signature: read only edit. Signature: Sean Jordison graphic.
That's amazing.
Signature.
All right, let's go ahead and check for accessibility. 32 of 32 categories and hit start checking. Tagged annotations failed, alternate text failed, but it actually does have alternate text. Sometimes the accessibility checker acts funky whenever it's ran through a third party program. Let's go ahead and open up the pack checker just to see. It does appear that it is reading correctly though, which is kind of more important than the other pieces of information. Let's test it though. I highly doubt it's gonna pass. Yeah, we get an error on the pack checker. Natural language is failed. WCAG. Let's do results in detail. Natural language of an alternate name of a form field cannot be determined. Interesting. So it's very close, but in terms of testing, the document is read aloud, so that's something. But now that the form has been signed, there's really nothing we can do to fix this. I guess we could try. Let's go to the tags panel, select the options button. Yeah, none of these options here are available for us to fix. That concludes today's video on testing the accessibility of a document using DocuSign. This seems to be a better option than Adobe Acrobat Pro DC or the eSign within Adobe Acrobat. However, if your organization wants all of the green checkboxes from the pack tool in Adobe Acrobat, it's still not gonna work, but based on some of this testing, it does feel like DocuSign does maintain a little bit more of the accessibility, actually a lot more of the accessibility than Adobe eSign. If you wanna find out how I can help you get accessible, take a look at the link in the description of this video. And as always, I could be your champion for inclusion. Thank you so much for joining me today, and I'll see you next time.